Let's start with the ESPYs, okay? Your boy Kyler Murray, did you really try to convince him not to go?
No.
He couldn't hang out with us? Is that what it is about? That wasn't the deal.
I wanted to go. But, I said, the last time I was out there, I was only out there for 24 hours. We left SEC Media Days, flew all the way out there, got on the red carpet. Great deal with Johnny. And, my big deal was he said, I'm going to leave on Monday and I'll be back next weekend. So he took a week out of
it. Oh, I see. He tried to extend the trip.
What a great award.
Yeah.
And for his family, to be just the
player of the
year across all sports. That's a great honor, and it's something that, hopefully he enjoyed it, and I'm all for going back, and hopefully he gets back.
And you told him that the incumbent Kyle Allen, that's a week that he will be getting better. So I think your depth chart is Kyle, Kyler, Kylis.
And Kylis. Yeah, that's what we're looking for. So. If your name starts with K-Y-L-E and anything else, you got a pretty good chance to play the
That makes it pretty easy, in the huddle or even when it's going to call them.
I just wonder, why couldn't it have been Kyle? Like, did you just call them both Kyle? Like, forget it, man. The arm is jacked. Like, no, it doesn't exist.
I think what's important is they're both great players.
Yeah.
And competition is a coach's best friend. And, the old saying, if you got two quarterbacks, you don't have one. That's not the case at Texas A&M.
Okay, now Kyle Allen, you got out of Arizona State or out of Arizona last year, correct? Right. And you had a coach's fundraiser Sunday night, and you said that you're sure Ty Graham will be real excited to come here. You guys played him in the opener.
You just keep trying to stir.
No, I'm just curious.
You're
the one that hashtags yes sir after you get a recruit.
Right.
But you took the liberty of pointing out that you've taken top recruits out of Arizona the last couple of years, and you got Arizona State, the Sun Devils, coming to Texas to play you in Houston in the opener. I'm just saying, if one of your players had given that kind of bulletin board material, what would you do? What would you say?
No. Coach Graham is an ex high school football coach in the state of Texas. Mm-hmm. Playing in Houston in a neutral site game, it's going to be a big game. They're going to be probably a top 20 team, and looking for a great year. So yeah, we take pride in recruiting and
just having fun.
We've got. It's just a fact. We've gone over there and between Kyle Allen and Christian Kirk last year, a couple of top players there in the state, and we've been fortunate enough to get them to come to Texas A&M.
Yes, sir. I was joking with you a few moments ago about you talking about going into Ty Graham's backyard and getting players. What is it about people coming into your backyard or really your house in general? Like this cat the other day said he was going to ding dong ditch, I think it's called, your front door. And you were like, hey, you better get over that fence. did he ever do it? He got a lot of retweets out of this.
I think it was 100 retweets and he was going to ding dong ditch.
That's a low barometer, too.
Did he do it?
No.
Okay.
That wasn't going to happen. That was not going to happen.
So, what about the
plan? The picture he took wasn't even my house.
Okay.
He wasn't even.
So somebody got ding dong ditched.
Maybe he thought it was me, so I really didn't have much to lose right there.
What about the pool boy you fired?
No, come on now. You guys.
You tweeted about everything, coach.
No, around my house. Listen, the big deal is, I've got a family, I got kids, and,
I feel you.
When you come to your house, whether you're there to work, whether you're there to do something, just like our family, there's got to be an issue of trust.
Privacy.
Privacy.
Yeah. You're on the phone with John Chavis, I think it was.
No. That's not. Come on.
You said it on Mike and Mike. You were on the phone with your new defensive coordinator, John Chavis. Great hiring, by the way.
We hired him, but not. I was not on the phone with him.
Okay. We're journalists trying to get the story straight.
I was on the phone.
Okay.
And then, we hadn't really settled on who was coming
right
as a defensive
coordinator. So for those that don't know, the pool boy tweeted, like everybody does, I'm watching Coach Sumlin on the phone, hopefully it's our new defensive coordinator, and you tweeted him, you're fired.
And for the record, we were both with you, what you doing?
He got fired.
Yeah, exactly.
No, just wonder if you know his whereabouts, like if he's going on a path of destruction, now that he's no longer,
Was he never rehired?
And the real issue is, when you're on the phone and it's such a sensitive issue that your wife and kids, you're outside trying to talk until nobody can hear you.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy does that, it's kind of a privacy issue. So you know, it wasn't that big a deal. I actually didn't get him fired from his complete job.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I just
can't do your house anymore.
Pool boy, the pool company owner said he just can't come back here.
Okay, well, I got you. That?
Go ahead. I'll
tell you what, while we're on the subject of privacy, something you didn't tweet about necessarily, but we heard about. So we try to confirm it. We try to get the story straight. Mm-hmm. Did you really take Johnny Manziel to a Rick Ross party?
No.
Oh, man.
No, that's all, you know, that's, what's his name? He made that up.
Made that up?
Made it up. Yeah, he said, yeah.
Skyly? I came with him. Was it
Robert Stolly, I think it was?
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Yeah, no, that didn't happen.
That didn't happen.
Do you like Rick Ross?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
We at least got that part straight.
Now, I may have gone.
Oh, okay. Oh, you went. Okay.
It was not a party. It was a concert. And so you guys know I've been to different concerts.
Mm-hmm.
So here and there, and there's been pictures taken, and I had an opportunity to see Rick Ross at the national championship game.
Nice.
Right after the game, there were a lot of people there.
See, so. I thought, okay, so there you go. You just want to clarify, get it technically right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're
on the premises.
It's like everything else, like who you're on the phone with, what you're doing. You know, everything gets lumped into something.
Right.
Yeah, I like to go to concerts. I've been to a few. You know that.
We have too.